Welcome back to our microeconomics session. Now, so far we have studied the perfect competition and we have started the basics of a monopoly. Now, we are going to learn some more curves in monopoly. Now, I know you are very much confused regarding how these curves work. So, in the starting session, I am just trying to tell you how do you draw these graphs so that you don't get confused, because this entire theory of perfect competition, imperfect competition and altogether the market equilibrium is all about your curves, right? So, when I tell you any market which wants to maximize the profit, what you are going to do is you are going to draw three curves, because the MR curve will be different for different competitions, right? When I say average cost, it is always going to be a U-shaped curve, correct? So this is your average cost curve. Now basically we are going to focus on the long run here. So if this is your AC curve, then you know that the MC curve will cut the AC curve from its minimum point. What is the minimum point? This is the minimum point. So you can come directly the reverse also, because what you have to do is from this minimum point you have to cut. So MC curve is nothing but a right shape curve which goes straight upwards after a certain point. This is the rising part of SMC, which is the supply curve, because as you go on wanting to produce more and more, supplying more and more, your cost will also increase. That is nevertheless the same thing that we have been studying so far. So this is your MC curve. Now these two curves are going to be the constant curves whatsoever in every form of market, because as we all know, when we start, both these curves are decreasing, but after a certain point, a additional input that I want to hire is what little bit expensive. That is why the MC curve goes on increasing even when the AC curve is decreasing. But when AC is at its minimum, that is the point where MC rises rapidly, because each additional unit that you are going to hire now is going to be expensive. It is so simple when you think from the point of view of a producer, and if you are, your product is getting recognized in the market and it is going to get more and more profits, the people that you are going to hire for doing certain job are also going to demand more from you. So accordingly the cost goes on increasing. See, after this cutoff point, what happens is AC also goes on increasing and MC also goes on increasing. Since MC is about the one additional unit of input that you are using or employing, it rises rapidly, and AC is altogether about your all the costs, the total fixed cost, the total variable cost in case of short run, and in case of long run only the variable cost. So that is why it is a bit flatter U-shaped curve. So these two things you have to remember. Others, all things will go on changing with your change in nature of competition, and that is how you determine the equilibrium or the economic profits or no profit, no loss situation. That is your normal profit, right? So in case when you are talking about a perfect competition, you know that MR is a straight line. MR is nothing but your price line, MR is nothing but your AR, and MR is nothing but your demand curve, correct? Because since in perfect competition we have seen that neither the producers nor the consumers have any control over the prices, the demand curve is your revenue curve and it is a horizontal line always. The demand curve is your MR curve in case of perfect competition, because you have absolutely no control over the prices, correct? So this price line, and whenever in any sort of competition you are talking about getting the maximum profit, you always have to refer to a point where your MR is equal to MC. So this is MR is equal to MC. Now this is the case of a perfect competition. Now today we are going to learn With these two basic curves, how are you going to determine the profit or the rationalized quantity? When I say rationalized quantity, you do not want to think that this is some sort of, you know, hi-fi term and then you will not be able to understand. Rationalized quantity means the quantity which as a producer you will think that this is my profit maximizing quantity. So this is your MR is equal to MC. So here also MR is equal to MC, and then on the x-axis we know that we always measure quantity. So this Q right here is your rationalized quantity, correct? So today we are going to see how does a monopolist under monopoly maximizes his profit. What is the demand curve for a monopolist, right? In yesterday's session, we saw how a monopolist firm is a price taker, how he decides his own prices, correct? Today we are going to focus more and more on the very important feature regarding price making behavior, that is the price discrimination, correct? So for example, let's say I am telling you price discrimination. Now suppose I am telling you that being a monopolist, you have the right to fluctuate the prices, charge different prices for the same product to different consumers, but it is not always possible, correct? You will say, no, it's not possible. Maybe, for example, the product that you sell is, you are in a hotel industry, right? Because some hotel industries also, you know, work under monopoly. Now, pure monopoly, you may not be able to find as much you can find industries which work very close to monopoly, right? So, for example, let's take a hypothetical example that you are in a hotel industry, right? And then you want to rent those rooms. And for example, you are renting like 5,000 per night a room. So you can differentiate the prices, do you think, or you can't? If you are talking about a normal scenario, you cannot. But if you are talking about a 5-star hotel, and then they can differentiate the prices. If they know there is some big party, like some businessman or some international investors, so they have the capacity, they have the purchasing power more than that of a normal resident or normal person who would want to, you know, rent the rooms, so they will discriminate. This price discrimination is totally at the discretion, at the sole willingness of whom? The monopolist. So we are going to see right here two conditions, and we are going to see how the MR works in case of your monopoly firm, and then how the monopolist decides whether to discriminate the prices and what is the effect on his profit of this discrimination. Because ultimately, whatever you do, whatever behavior you study, what you have to keep in your conscience is that you are a producer. Doesn't matter in which market firm you operate, you are a producer, and all you want to do is maximize your profit. So we are just going to see two different scenarios. Now let's say this is your first scenario, and as usual, you know this is your demand curve. Correct? This is your demand curve. For any individual, higher the price, low is the quantity demanded. If let's say the demand is too much, then you will not be willing to demand anything like that. Correct? And when the demand is low, price is lowest, the demand will be like the maximum. Correct? But here, one important feature that you have to note is in the monopoly, the demand curve is not same as the MR, or the marginal revenue curve will not be equal to demand curve. The only factor is that because what? The prices are not determined by the invisible hand of the market forces, but monopolist, he himself is in the position to determine. So it is said that MR curve has twice the slope, okay? It has twice the slope of your demand curve. And as I told to you in the very beginning, that MR curve or marginal curve in any concept goes to negative. It has the tendency to be the positive figure, then go to zero and also turn to negative. Now you will ask, how can a revenue be negative? We will come to that also. How can a revenue be negative? Because revenue are the earnings. How can earnings be negative? That happens when you are a monopolist. You go on discriminating prices so much that you lose the attention of whether whatever you are earning is above and beyond your cost or not, right? We will come to that later slowly, but you understand one thing, that the MR curve slopes twice the rate of demand curve. Means whatever is your demand curve, of that demand curve compared to that demand curve, the MR curve is going to slope twice the slope downwards. Means you can see it is downward sloping. I'll just draw it very conveniently here. MR. Okay, it goes to negative also. Now what we are going to learn here is, what about the price discriminating factor? For example, let's say, like I told you, 5,000 per night. Okay, this is your rupees per unit. Now unit is your hotel room, correct? Now someone, let's say one person who is renting your room, is ready to pay this 5,000, but somebody else comes and you know his willingness is not to pay 5,000, so you say, okay, I can charge you like 4,000 rupees. But what will happen then? You, sometimes it is not possible for you to exactly, you know, same thing to sell for different prices. So what will he do? He will not only change this 5,000 to 4,000 rupees for one person, but he will have to, in general, what he will have to do is, in general, he will have to reduce the prices. Means he was earning this much price into quantity. This is the maximum. But then what he will do is, he will want to reduce it. Now here, what you have to see is the cost curves. Obviously, whatever he is earning, apart from that, he also has to recover his own costs. So for example, this is my MC curve and this will be my AC curve. Now like I said, it does not change. See, this is MC and this is your AC curve. It does not change from the minimum point. MC will cut the AC. So at any given point, what is your profit maximization point that I told you to remember? MR is equal to MC. So this is your MC, but this is your MR. So this is going to be your equilibrium quantity. Means you will want to sell this much quantity of rooms, correct? So now tell me, what is the price, what is the revenue that you are going to earn for all the demand that you are going to get? Now you will, you know, want to do what is this? You will want to immediately take it as a corresponding. But I told you yesterday that the demand curve is different. This is the demand curve, right? So this becomes your price into quantity. This is your quantity, this is your price. This much is the price that a consumer, every consumer pays, because in certain kinds you cannot discriminate. So this figure what I'm showing here is no price discrimination. Here it is not possible for you to discriminate the prices for the exact same product. Now being a monopolist, you have the power to discriminate, but sometimes it is not possible for you, right? So suppose it is not possible for you, they were actually ready to pay 5,000, but due to some conditions, now nobody is ready to pay 5,000, and then you have to reduce the prices. So you reduce it to say 4,000, correct? So MR is equal to MC. This is your MR curve right here, black one. This is your MC curve. Wherever they intersect, this is your equilibrium quantity, or you can say this is the quantity which is promising you the maximum profit possible. But how much ever you are tempted to go correspondingly here, no, In monopoly, the MR curve and the demand curve is not the same. So in order to determine the revenue for the total quantities that you sell, you have to go to the demand curve. How much is the demand? This is the demand curve. So you plot it correspondingly on the demand curve and then you go to the price line. Correct? So this becomes your price line. This is your P and this is your Q. So this rectangle right over here is what your revenue. Now we are more interested in profits when there is no price discrimination. So how can you determine profit? I don't think it is that much of a rocket science right over here. This is your AC, correct? So this becomes your cost. Right? From here to here, this is your cost. Now, why have I highlighted this thing here, right over here? Because what you have to do is, this is your profit making opportunity and up to here is your cost. So your cost is, your total cost is this much and your total revenue is quite higher. So what you can say is, this is your economic profit. Now, as much as I am saying economic profit, you have to still remember that accounting profits and economic profits are different. When you say you have positive economic profit, you mean to say that you are earning the opportunity costs also. You are covering the opportunity cost from the revenue that you are earning. So like I said, again, I'll explain this to you since you are very confused. There is no need to get confused. First, you draw the demand curve. And you know MR curve slopes twice the rate of your demand curve. So you draw a MR curve which should go to the negative. And then what happens is normal MC curve, normal AC curve. Now, like I told you, MR is equal to MC is the profit maximizing condition, is the rational condition for any producer to earn the profits or maximize the profits. Here MR is equal to MC. And this is the rational quantity that you will want to sell as a producer. But in order to determine the price line, what you have to do is you have to go and correspondingly touch it on the demand curve. I am telling you again, it doesn't matter how tempted you are to take this MR is equal to MC on the price line. Remember, in case of monopoly, the demand curve and the MR curve is not the same when there is no price discrimination, correct? Because each unit that you are going to sell is not having a price discrimination, and then what you have to do is you have to find the revenue. The revenue will be demand, quantity demanded, which is this vertical line, into this horizontal line on the y-axis, which always shows you the prices or the costs, right? So this bigger rectangle right over here is your revenue minus the cost. How will you determine the cost? Is nothing but the base of your AC curve. Right? This AC curve will show you, this is the base of your AC curve, and this AC curve is going to show you how much cost are incurred for that particular quantity. So this is the cost and this is your total revenue. So this shaded part right over here is your economic profits, correct? So two things that you have to remember in case of monopoly. First scenario, where you are not able to discriminate prices. What do you mean by not able to being discriminate the prices? It means that you have to in generally fluctuate the prices, either increase or decrease. You cannot charge 5,000 per night to one person for the exact same hotel room and charge 4,000 to somebody else who is going to stay, you know, exactly in the same on the same floor or exactly adjacent to each other. So what you have to do is you have to lower the general price, correct? So but the first consumer who came in was ready to pay the 5,000, am I right? So what happens is, this much he was ready to pay, this much, but due to general lower prices he is paying this much. So this triangle right over here, I'm shading it, this triangle right over here is what, this is called as consumer surplus. This is one of the most important element or most important concept which was given by Professor Alfred Marshall. He said in case of monopoly, what happens when the producer is not able to discriminate between the prices and he in general fluctuates the prices, there is always a part which is called as the consumer surplus. This is called as the consumer surplus. What is a consumer surplus? Something which a consumer was willing to pay minus what he actually pays. That is your surplus. Means you first thought that 5,000 per night room, if that is the cost, maybe I can afford. Means your willingness to pay was 5,000, but a monopolist could not discriminate between n number of consumers. So what he did was, he cut down the prices from 5,000 to 4,000, which comes to right over here, which is your price line. So 1,000 rupees is your consumer surplus. So whenever you say consumer surplus, it is what you were willing to pay minus what you actually ended up paying, what you actually pay. Now this consumer surplus is your consumer's profit, consumer surplus. And what is your economic profit is the shaded portion, the revenue minus the cost for the rational quantity that you are going to sell. So as we have seen, what happens to our consumer surplus and our economic profits when the monopolist discriminates his prices. Now we will see, does not discriminate his prices. Now we will see what happens when he actually discriminates his prices. Now here the most important thing that you have to understand, that when he discriminates the prices, what happens is he does not have to charge the same price for each and every consumer, leading the MR to be twice that of the demand curve. He can now get all additional revenue different from each different consumers. Means when there is a price discrimination in the monopoly, what happens is the monopolist can gauge or can guess the willingness to pay, the ability to pay of every consumer, and that is the additional demand that he will get in the form of marginal revenue. That is why the demand curve and the marginal revenue curve will be the same in case of monopolist who discriminates the prices. Correct? Whatever is the demand, for every demand he can charge as much as they will be willing to pay. Now this is a very extreme example, a very hypothetical example, but this will help you to understand better what a price discrimination means for the marginal revenue curve or the consumer surplus, or for that matter the economic profits of a monopolist. Let's just draw the MC curve and the AC curve just as that. Like I told you in the beginning of this session, that the shapes will not change at all. Now for a profit maximizing condition, what you have to find is MR is equal to MC. Like I said, that is the most rational behavior of any producer. So now this is MC, and where is the MR? There will be no MR below the demand curve. The MR is nothing but your demand curve. So this is the condition where MR is equal to your MC. And then you can draw the quantity of rooms, means the rational quantity, that being a hotel you are going to rent out, and what will be the price. Now you are very tempted to draw this line here. Okay, for one instance we can let it be that this is, say this is the price that you are letting. Now in comparison with this price, now we will see what is the cost of selling these quantities or renting out these quantities of rooms. This is the AC, the minimum point of AC is your cost, correct? This C here stands for cost. So this is your cost, but let me tell you, this single price cannot be the only price, as we saw in no discrimination, because now you are willing to sell from, let's say our previous example, 500 to let's say 250 also. Means this is the highest point which a consumer was ready to pay for. 5,000 rupees per night was your basic example. From 5,000 he can cut down and he can discriminate or charge different prices to different people for the same hotel room. Means the profit that he will earn will not be only this much, because this is not the only price. the price will be greater than this until it is reaching the highest point. That is why you can say the entire triangle above the cost will be your economic profit. Now, by understanding what economic profit is, when there is a price discrimination, no fixed price, at that time you can also understand that there is absolutely no consumer surplus. Means the monopolist will differentiate, will discriminate between prices only by understanding what is the consumer's willingness to pay. If you belong to a higher income group, I will discriminate the prices, I will charge you higher prices. That means if you are willing to pay that much, you will end up paying that much. So what you are willing to pay minus what you are actually paying is the same. So the consumer surplus will shrink down, and in extremist condition it will become zero. So the major difference that you saw was when there is no price discrimination, when in order to sell more and more quantity, the monopolist has no other choice than to reduce the prices overall, general, at that time MR will be twice the size of the demand curve. It will always be below the demand curve, and there will always be a consumer surplus because initially the consumer was ready to pay more than what he actually ended up paying. But when you discriminate the prices, the demand curve and the MR curve will be the same, the profits will be more. As you can see from the figure itself, here the economic profit was less, here the economic profit is considerably more. That is why this is the feature of profit maximization. The price discrimination is the main feature of monopoly because that helps him to maximize the profits. This is all for today for our monopoly, and in the next session we are going to have a complete differentiation between the perfect competition and the monopoly based on various features. Okay, see you next time. Thank you.